Myself Professor Khodde Rushikesh and we are discussing about nitrogen metabolism. You are watching BSc Botany Studies Classes channel. Here in previous parts, part 1 and part 2, we have discussed the definition, concept and role of nitrogen in plant. You must have understood how nitrogen is important for plant for proper growth and development, because many processes are dependent upon this nitrogen. So plant have to take this nitrogen, but these plants are unable to take directly atmospheric nitrogen. Still, atmosphere contain 78% nitrogen. For that, in your syllabus, the point is given that in part 3, we are discussing about biological method of nitrogen fixation. I have written shortcut for nitrogen word. So there is another method of nitrogen fixation available, already we have discussed, that is industrial method. We have discussed in a detail what this industrial method performs. You can find the description in first lecture. So here we are going to restrict ourselves in biological method of nitrogen fixation. In biological method of nitrogen fixation, the microorganisms which are especially live in a soil perform all the job of nitrogen fixation. So these microorganisms, especially bacteria, perform this job. These bacteria, listen very carefully, are known as diazotrophs. In short answer or in MCQ, this question generally asked, diazotrophs are the class of bacteria who are capable to perform nitrogen fixation. These bacteria, I am talking about properties of these diazotrophs. These are unicellular, prokaryotic in nature. These are soil-borne microorganisms. And generally, these diazotrophs shows two types of association or two types of fashion of growth. One is symbiotic and another is non-symbiotic. We will discuss one by one how symbiotic biological method of nitrogen fixation takes place and how non-symbiotic biological method of nitrogen fixation takes place. So the point I have written here is symbiotic method of nitrogen fixation. The first question should come in your mind is that, do plant require every time help of these bacteria for normal growth and development? The answer is no. First of all, try to understand this. If soil is rich with nitrogen already, if soil is containing plenty amount of nitrate, nitrite and ammonia, then there will be no need of symbiotic association between plant and bacteria. The other side is that if soil is deficient, you have to write this point, if soil is deficient, deficient means the soil is lacking nitrogen. Nitrogen is present in soil in the form of nitrate, nitrite and ammonia. If soil do not contain nitrate, nitrite and ammonia, which are usable form, then these plants would require the association of bacteria. So already we have said the bacteria which lives in a soil do nitrogen fixation are known as diazotrophs. These diazotrophs includes diverse types of rhizobium type of bacteria. So I am talking here about symbiotic mode of nitrogen fixation. I have drawn one bacteria here, I have drawn one plant here. We are saying that the hypothesis is that if The soil is deficient for nitrogen. Soil is deficient for nitrogen. Then plant and microorganism do interact with each other. This is very interesting. Scientists have proved this. For example, we do phone call to our friend or relative whenever we think about. So, or we have some work with them. Plant have work with the bacteria. For that, plant do communicate with these diazotrophs, or we can say rhizobium. The communication format is very complex and chemical way that plant possess some genes. Please listen carefully. Plant possess some genes which are involved in communication, and bacteria also possess some genes which are involved in this communication. So plant which contain genes are generally termed as NNOD, and bacteria which possess genes are considered as small NNOD. Okay, you have to remember this. This is very critical. What I am trying to tell you is that if soil is deficient for nitrogen, then plant will send signal to the bacteria. The signal is in chemical form. Chemical signal. This signal is known as isoflavonoid or betaine. So in one mark answer, you should write the name of chemical signal which are released by the plant for the bacteria. Okay. In response to this isoflavonoid, in response to these chemicals, bacteria start to migrate toward the plant. So bacteria will migrate and reach up to the root hair of the plant. Which part? Root hair of the plant. So here we are discussing about if soil is deficient for nitrogen, plant will secrete the signal. The signal is generally isoflavonoid or betaine type. In response to this signal, bacteria start to migrate towards the root of the plant, and they go to the root hair of the plant. So root hair, you should highlight this word. So it was the first step in biological method of nitrogen fixation, which is we can call as infection stage. It was the infection stage where you will have to write the signal released by the plant and bacteria movement toward the plant. So bacteria reach up to the root hair and infect the plant. So the infection is positive. Plant do not get harmed by this infection because it is symbiotic mode of nutrition or symbiotic mode of association. Plant gives carbohydrate to the bacteria and bacteria gives nitrogen containing compound to the plant. So we will discuss which types of compound and how these compounds get assimilated by the plant. But it was the first step of nitrogen fixation. I have highlighted infection stage. The second stage is nodule formation stage. So nodule formation stage, the word saying nodule formation. So what this step includes, we will discuss in a detail. So friends, I have written here a second stage, that is the nodule formation stage. So what this word nodule says? Some plant root shows, if you uproot the plant, as picture is showing to you, presence of nodules in the root, not on the root, directly inside you will see the bulging portion is there, because of that cancer like outgrowth is visible, that is called as a nodule. So the plant which belong to the family leguminosi, the plant which belonging to the family leguminosi shows the nodules to their roots. It is a very key characteristic of leguminosi family plants. All plants in that family shows nodules. Some plants from Poaceae family. Poaceae family is generally of grass family. Some grass from Poaceae family shows nitrogen assimilation or nitrogen fixation by a biological method, but you have to remember this. Without nodule. In competitive exam, generally these types of questions are asked because it is exception. There is biological method of nitrogen fixation, there is symbiotic method of nitrogen fixation, but without nodule formation. Generally, bacteria live in periplasmic space of the grass root. So I will wipe out this because it was just informative for you. What is important is with respect to our exam is that the leguminosi family member shows formation of root nodule. How this nodule get formed is our main perspective. So second stage was nodule formation stage. How this nodule formation takes place? Let's discuss in a step by step manner. So first, what we said, bacteria reach up to, it is root hair. This is root hair. Bacteria have reached bacteria have reached up to the tip of the root hair. Why root hair only? Because root hair are very microscopic, very few in diameter and enough to entry of the bacteria. If you look at the size of bacteria is almost around 4 to 6 micrometer. The diameter of this root hair is almost around 16 to 20 micrometer. So it is like a tunnel for the bacteria to enter. Once bacteria reach up to the root hair, the bacteria secretes or produces the factor is known as a Nod factor. Remember these words may be new to you. So Nod factor produced by the bacteria. Bacteria is producing Nod factor. Please remember this. It is not produced by the plant. So the Nod factor secretion causes, I will draw once again, and this is bacteria. Bacteria have Nod factor. Listen carefully, it is very interesting. Root hair have a protein known as lectin. Root hair have protein known as lectin. Bacteria have Nod factor, it is not a protein. It is a very big oligosaccharide structure, lipokitin oligosaccharide structure. The Nod factor is lipokitin oligosaccharide, means it contains lipid, chitin molecule and other saccharide molecules, means carbohydrate molecules. So it is very big structure. Nod factor from bacteria and lectin from the root hair do interact with each other. It is very essential to write the interaction between Nod factor and lectin causes the second step, that is curling of root hair. Curling of root hair takes place. Why curling of root hair takes place? Because of Nod factor and lectin interaction. Nod factor is with bacteria, lectin is with root hair. Nod factor is produced by the bacteria. So it is very much connected to each other. After curling of the root hair will look like this. Okay, so the curling of root hair is the most important step in nodule formation step. So I will wipe out this. So I have written something here. What I have written, first nodule formation step includes node factor produced by the bacteria. The second step is lectin on the root hair, already it is there. Whether bacteria is there or not, lectin will be there. Node factor and lectin interaction takes place and causes curling of root hair. Many students do mistake, they write curling of root. Curling of root cannot take place. It is very hard in nature. Curling of root hair takes place. So the curling, after curling of root hair takes place, the next step is that formation of infection thread. So I will draw one diagram to make you understand what I am trying to tell you. Once curling of root hair takes place, bacteria start to migrate and reproduce, and they reproduce and migrate in one line. It is very interesting. They reproduce and migrate in one line, so it look like a thread. Thread means we have threads in our cloth, dhaga. So the infection thread reach up to where? It is very essential. Another step is also, you will say, sir, every step is essential. Yes, all steps are essential, but each step is dependent on previous step. So you should know from where we have started and where up to where we have reached. So infection thread has been formed. Microorganisms, these rhizobium are moving towards the inside. So if you take a look at the section, I have shown one photograph here. The transverse section shows root hair, epidermis, cortex, endodermis, pericycle, then you have vascular bundle, then you have the pith. The vascular bundle, pith, pericycle region is generally counted as a stellar region. So bacteria move and reach up to the cortex. You have to underline this word. Bacteria reach up to the cortex. They live in the cortex. Once these bacteria reach in the cortex, they get stationary. They don't move after that. So I will write here. Bacteria reaches up to the cortex. Bacteria have reached up to the cortex. After reaching to the cortex, they get stationary, and the stage is known as bacteroid stage of rhizobium. Once bacteria reach in a bacteroid stage, they start to get bulged. They start to do multiplication, and you will find the root will develop such tumor like structure. In photograph also you can observe this. So this tumors like structure development takes place because of this bacteroid. These bacteroid are stationary bacteria. We are talking about the symbiotic nitrogen fixation, where the rhizobium category bacteria are involved, and we have reached up to the formation of nodules. Okay, so in next lecture we will discuss about what happen inside this nodule so that these bacteria can take nitrogen and create usable form and give to the plant, because nitrogen is in air, bacteria are in root, roots are in soil. So how this takes place is a discussion point in next lecture. Thank you.